Los videojuegos son nuestra forma de ocio favorita. Nos pasamos horas entretenidos con ellos. Nos ayudan a desconectar y relajarnos de nuestra vida cotidiana. También es muy probable que los videojuegos nos hayan ayudado a superar una mala racha, una temporada en la que nos sentimos bajos de ánimos o solos. Nadie pone en duda de la función terapéutica que tienen los videojuegos en casos de depresión y soledad, pero a veces se nos olvida que estamos ante un formato que va mucho más allá del entretenimiento. Hoy queremos ponernos un poco más serios y hacer un pequeño acercamiento a los beneficios que tienen los videojuegos en personas con autismo a través del libro de Stuart Keith, El niño que quería construir su mundo. Gracias a nuestro paso por el Festival Celsius 232, pudimos conocer a Stuart Keith, periodista especializado en videojuegos en el periódico The Guardian y escritor de la novela El niño que quería construir su mundo. En este libro, recientemente publicado, relata la vida de Alex, un padre de familia que está a punto de perderlo todo por no saber relacionarse correctamente con Sam, su hijo autista. Cuando la relación con su hijo parece irrecuperable, Alex descubre que gracias a Minecraft puede compartir tiempo y experiencias con su hijo. El libro de Keith es ficción, pero muchas de las experiencias de los personajes son situaciones reales vividas por el autor, ya que él también tiene un hijo autista que descubrió un nuevo mundo gracias a Minecraft. Le preguntamos por su salto a la literatura y la implicación de la relación con su hijo y el libro.
So my son is Zach. He's 11, and he was diagnosed on the autism spectrum when he was 7. But we kind of knew that he was possibly autistic from the age of about 2 or 3. So from the beginning, he had lots of problems. So he had very small vocabulary, and he found it difficult to socialize with other children. And he wasn't very good at painting or drawing. Didn't have the patience for it. But really soon, he got really interested in video games. He loved to play on the iPad, and he really loved technology. He was really good at technology. He'd watch us do things like go on Netflix, and he would reprogram our Netflix account when we weren't around to lock us out. And so he had a real feel for technology. So when Minecraft came out in 2013 on the Xbox, I started playing with him. And it was amazing. He just completely understood the game and what he had to do. And he loved building like weird little houses for himself, and he'd love to show us. And it was a real kind of revelation because he'd never made things before. I was really kind of moved and touched by this. It was a real breakthrough for us as a family. So I wrote a feature about his experiences for The Guardian, where I work. Little Brown, the publishing company, saw my article and asked me to write a novel about Minecraft and autism and parenthood. And so that's how the book came about. I didn't come up with the idea myself, I have to say. What inspired me through the writing process was that I felt like I was learning things about my own son writing the book. So a lot of the time in the book, I'm trying to imagine the world from the son's point of view. And that really kind of helped me understand my son's point of view as well. So it was weird. It felt almost like therapy, like family therapy. Writing the book made me think of, and often in the book I put Sam into like very difficult situations, like children's parties and being in the school playground. And these are really hard things for autistic children. But because I kind of explored them and thought about them for the book, it made me like much more, I don't know, empathetic with Zach. It made me understand my own son a lot better. So that my inspiration and what kept me going was the feeling that I was learning and maybe being better a parent, I think, maybe through writing everything down, I think.
El primer momento en el que un niño con autismo se pone en contacto con un videojuego es una experiencia extraordinaria. Muchos padres relatan cambios de comportamiento muy positivos al permitir que sus hijos se adentren en el mundo de Minecraft, y la experiencia mejora si los padres participan. Stuart Keith nos cuenta la experiencia de su hijo.
I actually got an early sort of demo version of the Xbox version, and so he was about 7 at the time. And we didn't play the PC version. We played the Xbox one because he was really used to the controller. And yeah, the first time we played it, we just, he loved like just exploring the landscape to begin with, just wandering around and chasing after sheep and chickens and not really doing anything creative. But after a while, he kind of built up the confidence to start making things himself. I think that's one of the great things about video games with people on the autism spectrum. like the rest of the world is very chaotic and unpredictable, but video games are very safe and stable. And my son knew that when he built something in Minecraft, it would be there when he came back. And that was my first experience of the game, was that, the most valuable first experience was that he would make things and he would have the confidence to do it. And I can completely remember the first time he made a house, and it was just this really, real kind of hodgepodge of different bricks and different materials, bits of sandstone here, bits of rock over here, bits of glass in the middle. It was a really weird kind of modernist building that he made. But he brought in my wife and me, and he sat us down and he like toured the house, say, oh, you know, this is where I keep my wolves, this is where I keep my chickens, and this is the bedroom. And it was just amazing. And he was learning new words all the time. So yeah, I can really remember those first days. And I still have the save file with his first house on it, so that we can go back and visit it, so like a memory. Often parents come up to me afterwards and tell me like what a miracle Minecraft has been for their children. You know, I know I've met lots of parents of children on the autism spectrum who are non-verbal, but yet because of Minecraft they're able to go onto a server and meet other people who play Minecraft and socialize with them, because in Minecraft you can build things together with other people. You don't really need to speak to them, you can just plan and make stuff together. So Minecraft has been a way for lots of children to make friends, even if they're non-verbal. And it seems to be really common that children on the autism spectrum love Minecraft. And I think it is just because it's a safe, interesting place to make games, and people with autism love systems, they love mechanics, and Minecraft has lots of both.
El acercamiento de niños con este tipo de condiciones a la tecnología se está demostrando muy positivo, y según va avanzando se van probando nuevas aplicaciones y experimentos para intentar comprender y acercarnos más a su mundo. Le preguntamos a Keith sobre la posible aplicación de la realidad virtual en este tipo de casos.
Yeah, I think virtual reality is really interesting because it's the most immersive form of entertainment. Like, you are actually in a space being embodied, so it creates a world around you. I think it's going to be very difficult for a lot of people on the autism spectrum, because I think it's going to feel maybe quite overwhelming. So it's going to have to be very sensitively handled. Like, virtual reality works very different from normal video games, in that people need to acclimatize to the environment, need to be very slow and gentle. So I think it could be really helpful, because one of the great things about video games is it allows people on the spectrum to practice certain situations. So I went to, this is a quick story, but I went to see Mojang, the developers of Minecraft, and they told me that they'd spoken to the parent of a small boy who was starting a new school, and he was a Minecraft fan. And he was really nervous about starting this new school. So what happened was, the school gave his parents the blueprints to the school building, and the boy made the school building in Minecraft, so that when he went to the school, he felt he already knew it. So Minecraft helped prepare the boy for a real situation. So I think virtual reality would be amazing for that. Like, for example, if you had a virtual reality simulation of a city like London, it'd be amazing for someone on the autism spectrum to be able to explore that environment and feel safe and prepared for it before experiencing it in the real world.
Los videojuegos nos entretienen y nos distraen, pero también nos ayudan y acercan a otras realidades. No debemos olvidar que detrás de un juego hay un complicado entramado de diseño que a nosotros nos puede parecer un simple divertimento, pero que para otras personas es una puerta a una nueva forma de entender el mundo.